Practical class, in the last practical class, for redox titration, I have shown the titration between between more salt and potassium permanganate. Today, in the titration, there are two titration in your syllabus. Today, the titration between oxalic acid and potassium permanganate. So, first write the question. You have given PPR. First write the question. PPR m by 20 250 milliliter oxalic acid PPR m by 20 250 milliliter oxalic acid and using this solution determine the strength of given KMnO4 solution. This is the question. Prepare m by 20 oxalic acid solution and using this solution determine the strength of given KMnO4 solution. Now you have to prepare m by 20 oxalic acid. How will you prepare m by 20 oxalic acid 250 milliliter? Molecular mass of hydrated oxalic acid equal to the oxalic acid formula COOH bond COOH dot 2H2O. Eta molecular mass hoche 126 gram per mole. So 2 ppr m by 20 250 milliliter oxalic acid কত লাগবে 126 into 1 by 20 এত গ্রাম হচ্ছে পার লিটার আর 250 মিলিলিটার তাহলে বাই 250 বাই 1000 ইকুয়াল টু 126 বাই 80 এত গ্রাম ইকুয়াল টু 63 বাই 40 1.63 কে 40 দিয়ে ডিভাইড কর গ্রাম সো দিস অ্যামাউন্ট অফ অক্সালিক অ্যাসিড ইউ হ্যাভ টু ওয়েট 1.58 গ্রাম অক্সালিক অ্যাসিড ঠিক আছে উইথ দ্য হেল্প অফ ব্যালেন্স ওয়িং ব্যালেন্স অ্যান্ড ডিজলভ ইন 250 মিলিলিটার ওয়াটার ইউজিং এ ভলিউমেট্রিক ফ্লাক্স দেন দ্যাট উইল বি দ্য এম বাই 20 250 মিলিলিটার অক্সালিক অ্যাসিড দিস প্রিপারেশন ইউ হ্যাভ টু ডান ইন দ্য ল্যাবরেটরি অক্সালিক অ্যাসিড সলিউশন উইল নট বি প্রিপেয়ার বাই টিচার ইউ হ্যাভ টু প্রিপেয়ার দিস অক্সালিক অ্যাসিড সলিউশন Now, what is the equation? You have to first write the procedure. I have taken potassium permanganate in the burette. You have already done this in class 11. The potassium permanganate solution is taken in the burette. And in the pipette, what we take? In the pipette, we take more salt. You take more salt and you have to take sulfuric acid, 4 normal sulfuric acid for titration because why sulfuric acid is needed? If you see the reaction, what is the reaction? You see the reaction, oxalic acid C2O4 minus 2 plus MnO4 minus plus H plus give CO2 plus Mn plus 2 plus H2O. So this oxalic acid titration take place in presence of H plus ion. So you have to add 25 ml M by 20 sulfuric acid. Now wait for few minutes. I have to prepare sulfuric acid 4 normal. 4 normal sulfuric acid will be supplied to you. You have not prepared this sulfuric acid. Lab it at tumadike supply kora hobe. Okay. This is the oxalic acid, M by 20 oxalic acid, IPPR by weighing 1.58 gram oxalic acid and dissolve in 250 milliliter distilled water. By using pipette, you take oxalic acid. We take 25 ml oxalic acid. This is the 25 ml oxalic acid I have taken. Now you have to add sulfuric acid, 4 normal sulfuric acid. 25 ml using a measuring cylinder, not by pipette, by using measuring cylinder. Okay. So this is measuring cylinder. By using measuring cylinder, we add 25 ml sulfuric acid. So in the conical flux, we first take 25 ml oxalic acid, then we add 25 ml sulfuric acid. Now you know the titration between oxalic acid and KNO4 is a very slow reaction initially. So initially you have to heat the solution. Otherwise the pink color will not discharge quickly. So you heat the solution for few minutes so that the temperature of the solution become 50 to 60 degree centigrade. You must remember this. During titration of oxalic acid and KNO4, you take oxalic acid and sulfuric acid in the conical flux and you heat the solution for few minutes. This until the temperature of the solution become 50 to 60 degree centigrade. Only initial heating is required because after some time when you add KNO4, you see the reaction. Oxalic acid reacts with KNO4 to form manganese ion. Here KNO4 is an oxidizing agent, oxalic acid reducing agent. Oxalic acid reduces permanganate to manganese ion and itself oxidizes to carbon dioxide. This Mn plus 2 ion acts as an autocatalyst. So after some time, when some amount of Mn plus 2 ion form in the solution, it catalyzes the reaction so the declaration of KNO4 becomes speedy. So you only need to heat the solution initially. When the some KNO manganese ion is formed, then it acts as an autocatalyst and it speed up the reaction. So I heat the solution using for few minutes so that the temperature of the solution rises to 50 to 60 degree centigrade. This is the hot solution. Now we add KNO4. You add the KNO4 solution, okay? You add KNO4 drop by drop. You add KNO4 drop by drop and stir continuously so that the pink color is discharged. This, see the process, you know this process, you have done in class 11. So in this way you add drop by drop until a permanent very light pink color appeared. You add drop by, initially for the first time you must add KNO4 very cautiously. This only drop by drop. When you know the initial first reading, then for the second or third or fourth time you can add KNO4 quickly. But in case of oxalic acid, you have to add KNO4 very slowly so that until all the pink color discharge, you have to shake. Titration is a very patient. See this, the solution become very light pink color. Now you note the reading. You note the reading. The reading is 25.5 milliliter. You note the reading and write in the tabular form. So in the tabular form, you must note the reading. What you write? Experiment number one, experiment number, volume of oxalic acid taken or volume of KNO4 required a titer value. These are the four column. So experiment number one, volume of oxalic acid taken 25 milliliter, reading is 25.5 milliliter. Now experiment number two, you repeat this process at least four times. In the final board exam, you must repeat this process at least four times and take the not average value but the concordant value. You know the concordant value means the reading which appear more quickly. So during titration, say first reading is 25.5 milliliter. Second reading 25.7 milliliter, third reading 25.5 and fourth reading 25.4, then what will be the titer value? 25.5, because it happens in two times. Concordant value means the reading which taken frequently, jeta bar bar ashe reading ta. Okay, now we repeat the process in the second time. We also repeat the process. You reject the solution, this wash the conical flux, again you take more salt, sorry, oxalic acid, not more salt. We take 25 ml oxalic acid. 25 ml oxalic acid using pipette. This is the 25 ml oxalic acid. Now we add 25 ml sulfuric acid. You repeat the process at least four times. For this reason, you have to prepare 250 milliliter solution. You add 25 milliliter sulfuric acid using volumetric, using measuring cylinder. Now again you heat the solution. You heat the solution for few minutes because oxalic acid reaction is very slow. you heat the solution. When you heat the solution, you constantly shake over the Bunsen flame. Don't hold the conical flux on the Bunsen flame in a constant position. Constantly shake in this way. Otherwise, the conical flux may crack for improper heating. This you constantly shake the solution over Bunsen burner. And you note, not so much heating, only the temperature rises to 50 to 60 degree centigrade. Then you add the KMnO4 solution in the same way. Until a very light permanent pink color appeared. So this is a slight deep pink color. The pink color must be very light. You note the reading. The reading is 25.7 milliliter. Here 25 milliliter. Now in this way, you repeat the process for 4 to 5 times, at least 4 times. Say next time, this I do not show this. Say it is 25.5 milliliter. And in the fourth time, it is 25.4 milliliter. Then what will be tighter value? 25.5 milliliter. This is the concordant value. Now after performing the experiment, you first find out the tighter value. Then you have to show the calculation. What is the calculation? So tighter value 25.5 milliliter. Now use this formula. If you see the equation, this is the equation, 2KMnO4 plus 5COOH bond COOH plus 3H2SO4 give 2K2SO4 plus 2MnSO4 plus 10CO2 plus 8HO. This is the final equation. You have to remember this equation because in the viva, the external teacher may ask to write you the equation that take place during titration. So here you note 2 molecule KMnO4 reacts with 5 molecule oxalic acid to form Mn oxalic acid reduced to manganese ion KMnO4 is reduced to manganese ion and oxalic acid oxidized to CO2. So write the formula. Volume into molarity of KMnO4 divided by volume into molarity of oxalic acid equal to 2/5. Why 2/5? Because 2 molecule KMnO4 reacts with 5 molecule oxalic acid. What is the volume of KMnO4? Tighter value 25.5 into molarity you have to found. Volume of oxalic acid 25, molarity koto 1/20 equal to 2/5. 5 de cut eta, 5 de kole koto 4, 1/4. Tale koto hocche, tale m equal to 2 into 1/4 into 1/25.5. Eta kale koto hocche 0.2, mane 0.5. By কত হচ্ছে 25.5. This will be the molarity of the solution. So 0.5/25.5. এটা কত হচ্ছে দেখেন একবার ভাগ করে. Point 0.019 equal to 0.019. 0.019 2. So this will be molarity. So molarity of the given K1O4 solution equal to 0.02. See so? Okay. Hello student, any problem? Then finally you have to write two precaution, at least two precaution. So one precaution, you should take the oxalic acid using pipette very cautiously. During titration, you should note that even one drop of KNO4 is not fall outside the conical flux, and you should heat the solution before titration. So these are some two or three precaution. So in the final board exam, you first write the purpose question, then you write how to prepare M/20 oxalic acid. You have to show the calculation, the 1.58 gram is weight taken and dissolved in 250 milliliter. Then you write the equation, the principal equation. Then you write the column procedure in brief. Say procedure means we take the KNO4 in the burette, we prepare oxalic acid, then we take oxalic acid in the conical flux using pipette and add 25 ml M/20 M4 and normal sulfuric acid, and then titrate it using oxalic KNO4 until a very light pink color appear. Note the reading and repeat the process for 3 or 4 or 5 times. Then you write the observation table and finally show the calculation and write the precaution. So this total practical carries 8 marks. Understood? Either KNO4 oxalic acid or KNO4 more salt, any one of the will come in the coming board exam. Hello student, any problem? Hello? Any problem? You fill up the burette with KNO4. Mark it up to 0 mark. I again repeat the process. Take 25 ml more salt, oxalic acid. Add 25 ml sulfuric acid. 25 ml sulfuric acid. Heat the solution for few minutes. Wait. I heat the solution using burner. Of the solution become 50 to 60 degree centigrade. Then you add K1O4 drop by drop and titrate with constant stirring. See, during the titration, you must shake the solution so that the K1O4 will distribute throughout the solution. Say very light pink color appeared. You note the reading 25.5 milliliter. Same reading 25.5. This is actual the titer value 25.5 milliliter. Okay. Then you calculate this. During calculation, you must write the equation 2K1O4 plus 5 oxalic acid plus 3 sulfuric acid give K2SO4, MnSO4, CO2 and water. That means 2 molecule K1O4 reacts with 5 molecule oxalic acid. So volume into molarity of K1O4 by volume into molarity of oxalic acid must be 2/5, or 25.5 into M by 25 into molarity koto 1/20 equal to 2/5. Then you calculate this. Okay. Hello student, understood? Hello, you must write all the practical in your practical notebook, and some date will be given. In this date, you will submit the copy. Okay. The date, actual date, in which date you will submit the practical copy, actually all practical copy, physics, chemistry, biology, that date will be given from school for each section. Each section you must come in school, either you or your guardian, and submit all the copies, practical copy. That date may be at the end of the December or maybe at the beginning of January. Okay, that will be inform you on the website. Okay. So in the PBS class and this class, I perform the titration, redox titration. This carry, you know, 8 marks. In the next practical class, probably in Monday. Now you remember the all the for the in the December month, all the class 12 chemistry class that is given to me will be the practical class, not theory class. So in the coming Monday, I show the salt analysis. This is very important practical. you already perform in class 11. The same syllabus is present in class 12. The salt analysis, that is the unknown cation and unknown anion, you have to identify right in systematic way. So in the next class I will perform some unknown salt analysis. Okay, two or three class will be taken for salt analysis. This also carry 8 marks, and then the organic functional group detection, that mean alcohol, aldehyde, ketone and carboxylic acid. These four functional group are present in your syllabus. You have given a unknown organic liquid and you have to determine which functional group present in your sample liquid. Okay, this carry 6 marks, so total 22 marks you have to done in the practical final exam. And another 8 marks is actually the project copy, viva and laboratory notebook. Okay, so by student, any problem, any question regarding practical side? You heat the solution until the temperature become 50 to 60 degree centigrade, moderate heating, moderate heating. Okay, hardly 1 minute or 2 minute, not more than that. Okay.